We begin with tragic news from Newmarch House. Confirmation this afternoon, another resident has died after testing positive for the virus. Anglicare has issued a statement saying the man had no immediate family, but everyone there is grieving his death. He's the 15th person to die at the aged care home near Penrith, where every staff member is now being screened.
We continue to sequence and take samples from whenever we find a positive and then match it. So we are making sure that we're looking at the genetic fingerprint for all of the patients associated with the Newmarch facility.
We'll have the full details from our reporter a little later. Well, New South Wales residents have been given a pat on the back. Premier Gladys Berejiklian pleased by the behaviour of the community on the weekend. More than 5,000 tests were conducted, with only one result coming back positive. A 7-year-old boy is the latest person to contract the virus, forcing Warragamba Public School to close down.
We've demonstrated from our experience in term one, best practice when it comes to isolating a case, shutting down a school, doing a deep clean, and then resuming activities as soon as possible once contacts have been established.
Learning from home will finish at the end of the week, with students returning to face-to-face classes from next Monday. Well, to breaking news now, and an update in the contest for the federal seat of Eden Monaro. State politics reporter Liz Daniels joins us live from Macquarie Street. Liz, you've just heard from long-rumoured candidate Andrew Constance.
That's right, Mark. I've just spoken to the Transport Minister and he's confirmed he will make an announcement on his future tomorrow to likely confirm that he is standing for the seat of Eden Monaro that was vacated last week by Mike Kelly from Labor. The path was cleared for Andrew Constance to stand today, with his friend and colleague Deputy Premier John Barilaro bowing out of the race.
I've got to make the best decision for me, my family, for the people of New South Wales, more importantly for the people of Eden Monaro. They've been through hell and back with the fires, COVID, drought. And the last thing we need is an argy-bargy about what is right for that seat. But for me, this has been a decision about what I can contribute.
Now, of course, Andrew Constance's profile was boosted over the summer after he stood tall leading through the bushfire crisis. He will stand against the Labor-endorsed candidate for Eden Monaro, who is Christy McBain. She's actually the Bega mayor, and the two of them led together during the bushfire crisis. If the government does win this by-election of Eden Monaro, it would be the first by-election in 100 years that a government has managed to snatch from an opposition, Mark.
Liz Daniels live from Macquarie Street, thank you. An end date has been set for the economic lifelines helping many Australians through the coronavirus crisis. Live to political reporter Fiona Willen in Canberra. Fee, when will all the support finish?
Well, Mark, there are a couple of different dates to note. So those on the Job Seeker Allowance are currently receiving $1,100 a fortnight, but on September 22nd, that payment will return to being $550 a fortnight. For businesses using the Job Keeper program to pay their staff during this time, well, that will end on September 27th. Now, at the moment, that program is providing payments of $1,500 per fortnight to eligible workers. And a Bureau of Statistics survey shows that 3 in every 5 Australian businesses have registered for it or will register for it. So when these measures were announced, the Prime Minister and the Treasurer did say they were temporary and intended as a bridge to the other side of the crisis. This was the Industry Minister today.
There was a finite life to JobKeeper, so we have been very clear that it was for a certain period of time. We are working to make sure that Australia restarts, gets back to work as soon as possible, and that there will be no further need for a JobKeeper.
But the concern is that even when businesses are allowed to reopen, social distancing measures are likely to remain in place. So that would mean restaurants, cafes, pubs and clubs, for example, couldn't operate at full capacity. And many businesses say if that's the case and they no longer have the support of JobKeeper, that's when they'll run into trouble. I spoke with a pub owner in Canberra this afternoon.
If they were to go back to what the restrictions were just before we shut, which was, say, one person every 4 square metres, that means that the whole pub, we could only probably have about 75 people inside and out, which would be very hard to operate and keep on all your staff, like if there was no JobKeeper.
So So 76% of accommodation and food businesses are using these wage subsidies to keep their employees on, and the government's been very firm that the economic support measures will run out after 6 months. So if it's not business as usual after that, well, it will be a very tough time for many businesses and their workers, Mark.
Fiona Willen in Canberra, thank you. Well, a woman has been arrested over the alleged stabbing of a 19-year-old man in Potts Point this afternoon. Emergency crews were called to Darlinghurst Road, treating the man for a stab wound at the scene before he was taken to hospital in a stable condition. Several crime scenes are right now being examined by forensic police. A 42-year-old woman remains in custody. A building in the city's south is in ruins after a fierce fire tore through overnight, flames swallowing the Kirrawee factory, threatening to leap into neighbouring businesses. It took up to 60 firefighters to contain the blaze. After 4:30, we'll tell you where investigations are up to. Westpac's cash profits have plunged 70% as the big bank today releases its half-yearly results. It's decided to suspend its first half dividend due to uncertainty about the future caused by the pandemic. The bank will still put mortgages and business loans on hold.